This is the most important video I've ever made, apart from the one with the goat on my OnlyFans page. Because I'm so invested in this product, not just as a tech reviewer, but as a consumer, I've been following XREAL for years now, and the idea that a device might actually open the doors for me being able to work from anywhere and not have severe anxiety when being away from my desk was exciting to say the least. So these are the new XREAL Air 2 Pros and the companion, the brand new Beam Pro. Here's my story. So the first thing I did when I got my hands on these was plug them into something without reading any instructions. And initially I was ever so slightly disappointed. I mean, it was cool, but not $549 cool. There was no extra displays and the screen just moved with my head. It felt like the equivalent of sitting in front of a 32-inch monitor from about a meter away. Then I did the unthinkable. I looked at the manual. First, I updated my MacBook, downloaded the Nebula software for Mac, and plugged the Air 2 Pros back in, and wow, I got a chill. I actually felt like all my hopes and dreams were actually about to come true. This time, I had a huge screen in front of me that actually felt like it's in an AR space. I experimented with the triple monitor option and actually found myself enjoying a single larger monitor, but equally found the double even triple monitor display options were super helpful for certain tasks. Despite some online complaints, I was pleasantly surprised by the Nebula software's fluidity. My experience on the MacBook was seamless, it's truly plug and play, but where Nebula really starts to shine is with the new Beam Pro. And this device solves a lot of compatibility issues and software hiccups seen on online forums. Let's take a look. So, introducing the brand new Beam Pro. I'll be honest, initially I thought there was little to no need for it. Now, after a couple of weeks of testing, I think it's a bit of a must-have and a very exciting device. Anyway, it's a standalone device that looks and feels very much like a phone. This one comes with 6 GB of RAM and 126 GB of onboard storage, with a micro SD card slot to add some more. There is also another model you can go for as well, which comes with up to 8 GB of RAM and 256 GB of storage. I will say though, so far performance on the XREAL Beam Pro 6 GB version has been top notch. Continuing on, it comes with 2 USB-C ports below, one to hook up your glasses and then one for charging the device, so you can charge and play at the same time. On the side, you have your volume rocker, power button, and then the multi-function button, which is used to switch between smooth follow mode and anchor mode, which I'll explain later on in the video. Now, the Beam Pro comes with some really nice rear view cameras. You get 2 50-megapixel 3D cameras, which really got me excited when viewing my photos on the XREAL Air 2 Pro glasses. Additionally, it does even have a 8-megapixel front camera, IP54 waterproofing, and a 4,300 mAh battery. Critically, it has Wi-Fi 6 capabilities alongside Bluetooth 5.2, which is how I got my ultimate mobile setup up and running, which I'll show off a little bit later on in the video. These specs are all very nice, but what does it actually do? Now, here's where things get really interesting. These XREAL glasses out of the box are pretty much just like any other AR glasses. They'll mirror your phone, console, or PC screen. It's exciting stuff, but not particularly mind-blowing. But these glasses have hidden AR powers, way more potential than just mirroring, and that's where the Beam Pro comes in. This little device unlocks the full magic, turning your glasses into true smart AR glasses, kind of like a mini, affordable, and way less dorky looking version of the Apple Vision Pro. The Beam Pro itself looks like a budget phone, and honestly, it kind of is, but it runs this Nebula OS based on Android 14, at least for now. And that's where the fun begins. Plug in the glasses and boom, you're right in an AR space with apps made just for XREAL. Plus, since it's basically an Android device with Wi-Fi, you can download all sorts of stuff from the Play Store, Netflix, YouTube, whatever you want, directly onto the device. The OS is completely unique. It has a little bit of a learning curve to it, but you'll get used to it in no time. You can open up to 2 different screens or apps at the same time, but you can't open 2 performance heavy apps such as YouTube and Prime Video at the same time. However, Parsec and Prime worked fine together. Now, to navigate the interface, you use the Beam Pro as a trackpad, and slash all, you can also use it as an AR remote, a bit like you would with a VR headset. The experience is smooth, fluid, and actually really satisfying to use. XREAL have cleverly implemented easy quality of life gestures and buttons to quickly get you back on track with what you're doing. For example, holding the home button will quickly recenter your cursor if you have moved off slightly. Moving back to the OS itself, you have two different ways of experiencing the Nebula OS. You have smooth follow and body anchor mode. Smooth follow will just follow your head, and you have the option to switch between small, medium, and large screen sizes in the top right corner. When in body anchor mode though, you can keep the screen planted in an AR space, but the most useful thing about this is you can move and resize the windows, making the window so big it almost feels like you're in a cinema with your nose pressed up against the screen. I did find this to be a little bit temperamental with the odd crash when combining certain apps, but overall I'd say it worked really well. On that subject though, you might find that on occasion videos don't play, and the way I've got around this is by ensuring I'm in smooth follow mode when plugging the glasses in and starting the Nebula OS up, and then playing the video in my desired app. And once it's up and running, I will then switch to anchor mode, and then I can resize the window and make the screen even bigger, and the videos will play absolutely fine. So I'll talk more compatibility with phones, MacBooks, etc., etc., later on in the video, but to surmise, the Beam Pro solves a lot of problems you might have with other devices. Yes, it is another thing to carry, but it can replace your laptop and even your whole workstation, sort of, if you're smart about it. Here's where things get even more exciting. So as well as a content creator, I'm also a full-time CGI artist, and I actually managed to not only edit a 4K video inside Premiere Pro on these, but I also managed to work 3ds Max outside on my balcony. This is super heavy 3D software. How, you might ask? Since XREAL have managed to bring pretty much all of the Play Store to the Beam Pro, I thought, why not try Parsec out? If you don't know already, it's a low latency remote connection software. So what I did was download that, install and link it to my home PC that's running a Ryzen 5950X and an RTX 3090, and then I hooked it up to this light Bluetooth keyboard and my pointer instrument from Lunar Artifacts. It's a mouse. And there you go, that's my setup. I'm hooked up to the Wi-Fi and working remotely without a hitch. Inside software like Photoshop, Premiere, 3ds Max, and even tried scripting out in a Word document, as you can actually download Google Docs directly to the device. Typing isn't my favorite on the glasses, I'll be honest. I feel like it's a little bit of a strain on the eyes, but everything else definitely viable. To finish my ultimate mobile setup off, I paired my MW08 Bluetooth earphones to the Beam Pro as well. You can't really wear over-ear headphones with these, in my opinion. It's not very comfortable, but Bluetooth earphones are definitely viable, but you can go completely without, as the XREAL Air 2 Pro glasses do come with speakers installed. So the sound quality is actually pretty good. It's not quite audiophile quality, but it is very immersive, and in my opinion, just right for what the glasses are meant for. I really enjoyed catching up with Rings of Power on these. Potentially controversial comment to make, do we like Rings of Power? Anyway, XREAL say that these glasses have cinematic wraparound sound, a new directional audio technology that ensures that only users can hear, offering better privacy, protection, and minimizing disturbances to others. I put that to the test. So at max volume, you can hear them when the glasses are off your head, I'd say from about a meter away from you. If you were in a library, for example, people could certainly hear it. Coffee shop, you'd probably be fine on max volume. 60% volume is probably your sweet spot for a completely private experience while still being able to enjoy your music or movie. So it is definitely viable to just use the glasses on, say, a plane without earphones and without annoying other people. I do wish they'd go a touch louder, but generally speaking, you're in for a really immersive experience, much like you are with the Nebula software on a MacBook. So I did promise we'd circle back to compatibility and general productivity with other devices. And we'll start with my experience with a MacBook. Beyond adding virtual monitors, you can tweak the distance and size up to a whopping 500 inches. It truly feels like a cinema experience. While text is readable even at smaller sizes, it does have a bit of fringing to it. Enlarging it via the Nebula software though makes it crystal clear, though you will need to move your head a little bit around. Still, it does beat hunching over a tiny laptop screen in my opinion. Other than the quite frankly breathtaking display, I was also quite amazed by just how bright the XREAL Air 2 Pros get. On paper, 500 nits of brightness is certainly nothing to write home about, considering the Galaxy Watch Ultra here reaches 3000 nits of brightness. However, when viewing through the glasses, everything just seems like it's ramped up to 100. I'd almost say in a dark setting, the glasses are almost a touch too bright for me. And this leads me on to ticking off one of my biggest hopes and dreams for these products, and that is working outside on a sunny day without compromise. The XREAL Air 2 Pros can handle it, and they have handle it well. This isn't just thanks to the incredibly bright screens, it's also aided by the electrochromatic dimming they come equipped with. There's three settings. The first essentially keeps the glasses see-through, then the next two stages get darker and darker, the last one blocking up to 99% of light. And if that still wasn't dark enough, there is a cover included, which will help darken things again. And when you do have this cover on, you'll get a completely immersive experience when you're outside, and you can see everything crystal clear, way, way better than you would on even a modern laptop. I tried editing a video from my laptop outside and it was perfect, literally just what I wanted. I had my timeline in front of me, my media panel off to the left. It was like being at my desk, but with bigger screens. Further complementing this experience is XREAL's color accuracy. Now, these glasses were built with work in mind, I'm sure, not just gaming. They are the world's first TUV color accuracy certified AR glasses, making them a reliable portable alternative to a usual workstation. And being a CGI artist, I work with color a lot, and I can actually genuinely notice the difference between these glasses and my monitors at home, and I'd actually be inclined to say that the glasses offer a much more accurate experience. Here's where things get a little bit complicated though. So I've tried these on my MacBook, my phone, and a couple of other different devices, and each device offers a very different experience. The best and most practical of those experiences being the Beam Pro and the MacBook. If we were to pair the glasses with my Z Fold 4, for example, we get a couple of different experiences in one. Just plugging them in and aircasting essentially mirrors your phone screen is cool, but not useful in my opinion. If you leave Samsung DeX enabled and plug the glasses in, this is a cool experience, as you suddenly have a low powered desktop PC you can use to edit documents and play media, but then you don't get the AR experience, so you can't add additional windows and resize the screen. Then there's a Nebula app. This was both cool and disappointing at the same time. The AR space initially very immersive, but not practical. YouTube didn't work very well, and there was big limitations when it came to app selections, so I couldn't really find a practical use case for this. Then on top of this, moving your head relatively fast would present severe screen tearing. So the Android experience isn't quite there for me yet, unless you are using it on the Beam Pro, which weirdly works absolutely flawlessly. My positive takeaway from this was unlocking the full potential of Samsung DeX. If you do have a more recent powerful Samsung phone, this could be a great opportunity to really make use of that feature. On a Windows PC, they don't really work. The software is still in beta. You can plug them in and get the screen mirroring effect, but it offered no benefit to me at my desktop. I'd rather just play a game on my PC and regular monitors. So I've spent a good amount of time testing the XREAL Air 2 Pros on several different devices, but what about comfort over a long period of time? So after a few weeks of extensive testing, I've got to say these glasses are surprisingly comfy most of the time. I'd say that you can comfortably wear them for about 2 to 3 hours before you might start to feel a little bit of eye strain, but everyone's different, so your mileage may vary. If it weren't for the occasional eye fatigue, I could honestly wear these glasses all day. XREAL nailed the weight distribution. They're as light as just 72 grams, and those new flexible arms on the Air 2 Pros hug your head really nicely. They come with three different sizes of nose pads, which you can switch out by just using the back of one of the spare ones to pop them off. On top of the nose pads, you can also adjust the glasses by pushing down on them, which feels a little bit risky every time I do it. And to be honest, I really hate doing it. So if XREAL could consider a different way to adjust the glasses, that would be perfect. Overall though, they have an impressive form factor, especially compared to the likes of the Apple Vision Pro. Although they are relatively subtle in comparison to other VR and AR glasses, I don't think we're quite at the point where you can wear these in public and get away with it, and you're definitely going to attract some sort of attention. But the silhouette isn't that wildly different from a thick frame pair of glasses. Now, one really important aspect we haven't touched on yet is gaming and movies on the XREAL Air 2 glasses and Beam Pro. If your main reason for buying these glasses was entertainment, then you're in for a bit of a treat, especially when it comes to gaming. You compare these virtually to any device with USB-C video output. Steam Deck comes to mind as a great pair. But I want to go back and check on the Beam Pro for a second. With it having access to the Play Store that brings apps such as Steam Link, Xbox Cloud Gaming, and then of course all your mobile games on the Play Store, it does open some doors. Whilst we're arguably not quite there yet when it comes to cloud gaming, there's certainly some games you can still enjoy. Temtem on Steam is a great one to try. This is a turn-based game similar to Pokemon. Games like this perform really well because the latency doesn't really matter too much. And to be honest, I did try booting up Starfield the other day via Steam Link, and it worked a treat. In terms of actual visuals, games look absolutely stunning, the colors pop, the screen size is awesome, and the sound is pretty good too. Faster paced games like Asphalt, for example, will also look great on the XREAL Air 2 Pros as they're equipped with a 90 Hz refresh rate if you are using them with the Beam Pro. Movies again, probably best viewed on the Beam Pro. You get a super immersive cinema-like experience. I found myself really enjoying movies the most in darker settings as you don't have quite as large of a field of view with these, so there is a small gap where a little bit of light during the day will come through into the glasses. But in my opinion, it is not all that distracting at all. My only minor negative point is that I have noticed the blacks are getting crushed just a little bit in some movies and games, but really not something that's going to ruin your experience at all. So should you buy the XREAL Air 2 Pros and Beam Pro now? I maintain what I said at the start. The glasses paired with the XREAL Beam Pro genuinely gave me goosebumps. They're exactly what I wanted, and it's like staring into the future. They're not quite 100% there yet as true reliable workstation alternatives. For a bit of freedom, you can certainly rely on these as a portable workstation alternative every now and then. The entertainment aspect of them is already there. You get a really cool immersive experience with popping colors and brilliant brightness. Sure, there could be improvements to the field of view, but that's what you get. That is the trade-off for when you go for an AR set of glasses that sort of help you blend into society a little bit more, as opposed to going for full VR goggles like the Apple Vision Pro, for example. Despite this, I'd honestly wager that many of you are going to be super impressed with the XREAL Air 2 Pros and Beam Pro devices. If you want to see some more tech though, do click in the top left or right hand corner now and consider watching 70 things to do with the brand new Galaxy Watch Ultra. For now though, I've been Alex. This has been Tech Easy. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.